Hello friends and welcome to this video. In this video we are going to see the finite difference method which is used to solve the boundary value problems and to get the solution of partial differential equations. In finite difference method, the derivatives in the differential equation and the boundary conditions are replaced by their finite difference approximation. So when we replace into finite difference approximation, then we will get the number of equation as per the number of unknowns. These equations are the linear equations which can be solved by any standard method by using the direct method like Gauss elimination or the iterative method like Jacobi or Gauss-Seidel method. If y of x and its derivative are the single valued continuous function of x, then by Taylor's expansion series we can write the expression in terms of y of x plus h as y of x plus h is equal to y of x plus h into y dash of x plus h square by 2 factorial into y double dash of x and so on. In same fashion we can write the expression in terms of y of x minus h. So the y of x minus h is equal to y of x minus h into y dash of x plus h square by 2 factorial into y double dash of x and so on. So if we observe this equation 1 and equation 2, we will get the same expression, but only there is the change in sign. So for second equation, there will be first sign as a plus, then minus, then plus, minus and so on. So using these two expressions, we can write the first derivative of y, that is y dash of x. So let's write using the equation number 1. So if we rearrange the equation 1 and writing in terms of the y dash of x, we will get as y dash of x is equal to 1 by h in bracket y of x plus h minus y of x square bracket complete plus other terms of the h values. And this is called as the forward difference approximation, as we get this next value minus the current value, that is the difference between next value and current value, so that why it will be called as a forward difference approximation. In same fashion, from equation number 2 also we can write the y dash of x value as y dash of x is equal to 1 by h in square bracket y of x minus y of x minus h value square bracket complete plus other higher terms, and it is called as a backward difference approximation because we will get as a difference between this current value minus previous value. And now we can write again the third expression in terms of again y dash of x as by subtracting the equation number 2 and 1. So subtracting the equation 2 from 1, we can get y dash of x value as 1 by 2h in square bracket y of x plus h minus y of x minus h value square bracket complete plus other higher terms of the h values. And this will be called as a central difference approximation, as there is the difference between the next value and previous value. So this central difference approximation is generally used because it is gives us the better approximations. Now again, in three ways we will be get the first derivative approximations. So generally we are using the central difference approximation to get the solutions. And now by adding equation number 1 and 2, we will get the double derivative of y, that is y double dash of x, we can be get by adding the equation number 1 and 2. So we'll be get this as y double dash of x is equal to 1 by h square in square bracket y of x plus h minus 2 into y of x plus y of x minus h value plus other higher terms. So we are neglecting all other higher terms, and this is also called as a central difference approximation. So generally we are going to use this central difference approximation to solve the boundary value problems as well as to get the solution of partial differential equations. As we are using the central difference approximation for most of the values, and this central difference approximation for the first derivative we get as 1 by 2h in bracket y of x plus h value minus y of x minus h bracket complete and all other higher terms. So this expression we are going to write in terms of the y of I value. So this equation can be written as the x value will be replaced as I value, x plus h value will be replaced as I plus 1 value, and x minus h value will be replaced by I minus 1 value. So we'll be get yi dash of x is equal to 1 by 2h y I plus 1 minus y I minus 1. Now same fashion, the double derivative can be written as yi double dash of x is equal to 1 by h square in bracket yi plus 1 minus 2yi minus yi minus 1. In same fashions, we can get the third derivative as y triple dash of x is equal to 1 by 2h cube in bracket yi plus 2 minus 2yi plus 1 plus 2yi minus 1 minus yi minus 2. And fourth derivative will be get as a 1 by h raised to 4 in bracket yi plus 2 minus 4yi plus 1 plus 6yi minus 4yi minus 1 plus yi minus 2. So we will be get these four equations. This is the first derivative, then second derivative, third derivative and fourth derivative. So whatever the differential equation we will be get, we need to convert into finite difference approximations by using these expressions. So let's solve one problem. So we have to find the value of y of 0.25, y of 0.50 and y of 0.75. We satisfy the differential equation d square y by dx square, that is the second order differential equation, plus y is equal to x, which is subjected to boundary condition y of 0 is equal to 0 and y of 1 is equal to 2. So here it is given that y of 0 is equal to 0 means the value of y at x is equal to 0 is 0 and the value of y at x is equal to 1 is equal to 2. And we need to find the value of y at x equal to 0.25, at x equal to 0.15 and at x is equal to 0.75. So by observation you can see that there are four intervals. So we need to divide this expression into a four sub intervals from starting from 0 and 1. So this is the initial value of x as a 0 and final value of x as a 1. So these we are dividing into four number of intervals, so we can easily get the value of h. So h can be calculated as xn value minus x0 value divided by number of interval, that is n value. So we will be get 1 minus 0 divided by 4, which is equal to 0.25. And we can write the different values of x as x0 value is given as a 0, so it will be written as x0 as a 0. Then x1 will be get as x0 plus h. So 0 plus 0.25 will be get 0.25. x2 will be x0 plus 2h, which will be get as a 0.50. x3 will be x0 plus 3h, which will be get as a 0.75. And x4 is the x0 plus 4h, that is the last value as a 1 value. Now using these values, first we need to convert the given differential equation into a finite difference approximation. So the given equation is y double dash of x plus y of x is equal to x, and which can be approximated as we learned in previously. So y double dash of x will be written as 1 by h square in bracket yi plus 1 minus 2yi plus yi minus 1 plus y of x will be written as it is y of yi, and x will be written as a xi. So first, by putting the value of h, we can rewrite the equation as the h value is 0.25. So 1 by h square will be get as a 16. So we will be get 16yi plus 1 minus 32yi plus 16yi minus 1 plus yi is equal to xi. Now in this equation, so we have to put the boundary conditions and also the I values from 1 to 3. So using initial boundary condition of y0 as a 0, this is the initial, and y4 as a 2, because this 1 at x is equal to 4. So we will get y4 as a 2 value. So using this and this first equation, by putting I is equal to 1 value in the equation 1, we can get 16y2, then minus 32y1 plus 16y0 plus y1 is equal to x1. Now putting in this equation y0 value as a 0, there is no y4 term, so we only need to put the y0 value as a 0, and rearranging the equation by taking all the coefficient values into the left hand side and only the constant value on the right hand side. Also we need to put the x1 value as a 0.25. So we'll be get the equation as 16y2 minus 31y1 is equal to 0.25. Now put I is equal to 2 in the equation number 1, and then we will be get 16y3 minus 32y2 plus 16y1 plus y2 is equal to x2. In this expression we need to put the x2 value as a 0.50, and then again rearranging the expression will be get as 16y3 minus 31y2 plus 16y1 is equal to 0.50. Now write the first equation by putting I is equal to 3. So we'll be get as a 16y4 minus 32y3 plus 16y2 plus y3 is equal to x3. Now we know the value of y4 as a 2, x3 value as a 0.75. So putting this value and rearranging the equation, we'll be get 31y3 plus 16y2 is equal to minus 31.25. So we having 3 unknowns, y1, y2 and y3, and we are having the 3 simultaneous equation. So by solving this three simultaneous equation by using any standard method like Gauss elimination method or Gauss Seidel method, then we will get the solution of y1, y2 and y3. So y1 value is nothing but y of 0.25, y2 value is nothing but y of 0.50, and y3 value is nothing but y of 0.75. That is the value at x1, x2 and x3. So by solving we will be get this y1 value as a 0.5443, y2 value as a 1.0701, and y3 value as a 1.5604. So in this way you can able to solve any differential equation by converting it into a finite difference approximation. Then using the boundary conditions you will be get the number of equations, and by solving that number of equations by using any standard method you will be get the solution of that equation. And in next video we are going to solve these partial differential equations using this finite difference approximations. So thank you for the watching.